world peace is conventionally too broad a topic for any 16-year-old to ponder about. But whenever I turn on the news and see the flashing headlines of the Yemeni civil war or the Israeli-Palestinian crisis, I can't help but be concerned about what is going on in this world. I simply never understood the reason for starvation, the reason for destruction, the reason for killing of innocent strangers, or for warfare in general. Take, for example, terrorism. Now, why would someone knowingly take the lives of faultless civilians who are total strangers? They don't even know them. And it's not that these terrorists are simply mad, or to put it in simpler terms, bad. In fact, studies show that 1 in 10 of them have mental health problems. Now, this is pretty alarming because this makes the rest 9 of them average men. Take, for example, the man walking down the street or the man sitting next to you on the school bus. And it's very frightening. When I think closely about it, I find it very difficult to make sense of it. So many other questions arise. Is mankind fundamentally evil? Is the human race going to be the end of the world? Now, usually, these questions are posed very superficially. But when you think more closely about it, they actually make a lot of sense. Now, we all know that it just takes one toxic person to sabotage another person's entire frame of mind. And this got me thinking. Frame of mind, what is it? How do you define a person as toxic? And if all this is true, isn't it also true that a group of negatively minded people would be enough to destroy the entire world? I thus concluded the cause for these evils, the human mind. When I further delved deeper into this idea and explored it further, I came across a saying by Buddha, that is, the mind is everything. What you think, you become. The mind is everything. What you think, you become. Now, when I further explored this idea, it came to my realization that everything depends on how an individual reacts to external stimuli. How does one person analyze another person's actions in their mind? Now, let's take a very common example. As a teenager, this is bound to happen sometime. Let's say you come home late from a party, and you're way past your curfew, so your parents yell at you. Now, how would you interpret this simple situation in your mind? Would you take it as concern from your parents' side and their attempt to make you a more virtuous person? Or rather, a restriction, your parents clipping your wings and holding you back from the more fun things in life? Now, this may seem like a very silly question at first, but I believe that answers to similar questions hold key to understanding a bigger picture. Now, if you interpreted this situation as a restriction, the insecurity of perhaps being misunderstood or not being good enough as a child could build up in you and later explode at an unwanted time. But rather, if you resolve any conflict or misunderstanding at that moment, this insecurity no longer becomes a part of you or an insecurity that is part of your identity. In my opinion, these simple differences and inability to resolve conflict is what hinders world peace. It may seem very ridiculous to hear at first, but hear me out. Now, let's take a wider scale example. The world's worst humanitarian crisis in Yemen, that is the Yemeni civil war. If the political transition to the Haiti government had been treated with just a little more patience, or the two parties willing to take a step back and understand the intentions of the other, it is quite possible that thousands of people wouldn't be dead and millions of people wouldn't be displaced. Likewise, bottled up thoughts often lead to violent outbursts. Let's take another instance, that is the Boston Marathon bombing of 2013. The ringleader, Sarnaev, was originally a non-practicing Muslim. But after his dreams of being an Olympic boxer failed, he converted to an Islamist militant. And at the time of the bombing, he was not only unemployed, but also in a skewed sense of perception, he believed that bombing this marathon allowed himself to be a hero in his own eyes. Hence, I rest my case. A solution to this seems impossible, doesn't it? But in my opinion, it all comes down to matters of perspective. The practice of seeing the good in people, the good in situations, the good in actions, all begin with positivity. My mother often tells me that our thoughts influence our actions. So positive thoughts would equal positive actions, right? This seems pretty simple enough to make one person's life better. Now, what if we apply this simple equation to the rest of the world? Let's talk about the ripple effect. Robert Reiner once said that everybody talks about wanting to change and help and fix. But ultimately, all you can do is fix yourself. Because if you fix yourself, that's a lot. It has a ripple effect. The actions of individuals have far, far-reaching effects. And I strongly believe that the beginning of world peace starts with us, me and you. In fact, I strongly believe that the beginning of world peace starts with a single positive thought. Thank you.